Richmond won by 28 points back in round 19. That's the last time the two teams played. You're sitting in the grandstand watching.
Yeah.
What did the club take from that game going forward then?
There was a lot to like, especially in the first half, the first three quarters. I thought we matched up quite well. We actually played a similar brand of footy to each other. We just couldn't finish off for four quarters. I think we lost a couple of blokes early, which never helps. But Richmond, they're a great side, and we're looking forward to the challenge. It will be a big challenge.
Well, being involved in that game, Lee, it sort of was a finals type game. Yep. The atmosphere and, like Goldie said, the brands of footy that were played was similar to a final.
Now, Sean, you're at Richmond, and the 6-day break that Collingwood get is because Richmond, top team, win qualifying final, go Friday night preliminary. Obviously, there was some talk last week from the other side of the equation with Eddie Maguire.
Did Eddie say anything, did he?
Well, he thought, but I mean,
strange.
If we look about the fairness of it, like, I always thought top team, win qualifying final, gets the Friday night preliminary final. Don't we all think that's what footy happens for the last 20 years?
Yeah, I think that Richmond have earned the right to play Friday night and get an extended break to the grand final or, you know, if they make it.
Yep.
Hopefully they don't. Yep. But, I mean, a six-day break in the modern era is not that tough. I mean, maybe it used to be with heavier grounds, but these days we have, you know, the best facilities in the world. And if you can't recover for 6 days, then you're doing something wrong or you're not really tipping in. So I'm confident we can get our bodies right to go. You just have a slightly smaller training session during the week, which we don't mind.
Perfect for a
player. You're coming up against a side that's got a different ruck set up. I think they've got a conventional ruck with one that's the second smallest, Babushka. But how much time do you put into that? Because it really works for the Tigers. It's one of their real strengths. They've got the ability to play a different structure.
Well, I think the positive of that is that they get another mid around the contest. We have Brody Grundy, who essentially is another mid around the contest as well. So I think we can match that quite well in the way that Bros goes about it. And Lee, you were saying earlier, his spread from a contest and how hard he can work through to the last quarter is a real strength of his. So
does he spread as hard as the second ruckman for Richmond, Sean Greer? Do you even do ruck training, Sean? Because you're the shortest second ruckman ever.
I do stick my head in Ivan Marek, his office. He's our ruck coach. So I do stick my head in his office and he tells me to scoot down the hallway pretty quick, actually. So
now, this is the tallest second ruckman in the game and the shortest what's your chance of getting hit out, you reckon, against Mason Cox?
I've missed time the jump there, Lee, haven't I think. But,
otherwise, you would have been all over it, you reckon?
Yeah, well, I'm 50-50. I'm either going to win the tap or I'm not. So 50-50 chance.
Hey, speaking like ground-level players, we reckon the hit-outs mean nothing anyway, to be honest.
Yeah.
Who are you going to go to this week? Obviously,
I'd have
to go to Jack, wouldn't you?
I'd take it, if they want me to go to him. If it's Caddy, I'll go to him. Cassania, I don't care. And I said that against Kennedy or against West Coast and against GWS. We haven't gone through Richmond yet, so I actually legitimately don't know who I'm going to. But as a back six, we'll just take whoever comes and we'll work it out.